Recall that the adhikara of bhave and akartricha karake sanyayam goes from 3318, 3319 down to 33112. Let us now move beyond adhikara. Let's go further and take the sutram 33114, napumsake bhavek taha. So the anuvritti of 3318 bhave and 3319 akartricha karake sanyayam does not come into the sutram 33114. Because it stops at 33112. Also remember that the sutram 33113, Kritya Lyuto Bahulam, that sutram we have already studied in connection with the Kritya Pratyayaha. When we are studying those, we already took up the sutram Kritya Lyuto Bahulam. So we won't take that again now. Let's now take 33114, Napumsake Bhavek Taha. Vritya of this sutram says, Klibatva Vishishte Bhave Kal Samanye Ktah Syat, which means that to express bhava, which is the sense of the verbal root as having attained to a completed state, the affix kta may be used as long as the word so derived is used in the neuter gender. And it may be used to denote this action in any time frame, past, present or future. Now why does the vritti say kal samanye? Because remember the sutram 32102 nishtha. That sutram already prescribed the nishtha affixes. What is nishtha? Taktavatu nishtha 1126. So the two affixes kta and ktavatu get the nishtha sanya. And 32102 nishtha prescribes the nishtha affix. And we also know from 3470 tayoreva kritya kta khalarthaha that the affix kta is to be used bhavakarmanoho. Tayoho means bhavakarmanoho. So now we already have a sutram 32102 describing the affix kta in the sense of bhave as well as karmani. And why do we need this sutram 33114 now? So why is Panini again composing 33114? Because 32102 looks like we could use that one. That didn't say any specific gender, so it'll work in all three genders. It prescribes the affix kta bhavakarmanoho. So what's the point of this one now? The reason is that the sutram 32102 comes in the adhikara of bhute, which starts from 3284 and goes down to 32122, right before vartamani lat, which is 32123. So bhute stops at 32122. Let's not forget that. So that sutram nishtha 32102 may only be used to denote an action which has been done in the past, not in the present or future. Now we understand why the vritti of this sutram 33114 says kala samanye, that this affix kta, the affix is the same, kta is the affix, but here by 33114 is being prescribed without restriction to the time frame, past, present or future. That is why we need this sutram. But this sutram says that it's to be used to derive a word which must be used in the neuter gender. And it's only in the sense of bhave, the sense of the verbal root as having attained to a completed state. So that is what this sutram says. So the meaning is the affix kta may be used following a verbal root to denote in the neuter gender the sense of the verbal root as having attained to a completed state, which is bhave, without restriction to the time frame, past, present or future tense. So please keep this distinction between 32102 and 33114 clear in the mind. One more to note here is that we already know the sutram 3318 bhave, which prescribes the affix ghanya bhave. That sutram did not say that ghanya is to be used in a specific gender. This sutram 33114 prescribes the affix kta, also bhave, but only to derive a word in the neuter gender. So therefore, this affix kta prescribed by the sutram 33114, napumsake bhave kta, it is an exception, apavadaha, to the affix ghain prescribed by 3318. Just like 3394, striyam khtin, the affix khtin is apavadaha to ghain. Similarly, this affix kta prescribed by this sutram 33104 is apavadaha to the affix ghain prescribed by 3318. So that is how, barring exceptions, the affix ghain is used bhave only to derive word in the masculine gender, because in the feminine gender 3394 comes and prescribes the affix ktin as apavadaha, and in the neuter gender 33114 comes and prescribes the affix kt as an apavadaha. So in the remaining gender, which is a masculine gender, the affix again comes bhave by 3318. Okay, there's one more thing important with regard to the affix kt prescribed by this sutram 33114 versus the affix kt prescribed by 32102, and that is in relation to the vibhakti, the case ending, to be used with the connecting word, the word which connects with the word derived by adding the affix kt. When we derive a word using the affix kt by the sutram 32102 nishtha, then the connecting word takes the tritiya vibhakti. For example, balakena hasitam means that the act of laughing was done by the boy. So we can say in English, it was laughed by the boy. Or if you want to make it active, the meaning basically means the boy laughed. But the literal meaning is, it was laughed by the boy. The act of laughing was done by the boy. So balakena ends in the tritiya vibhaktihi. Now contrast that to what happens when we use the affix kta by this sutram 33114. We get the same form hasitam, but now we use a shashti vibhakti with balaka. Balakasya hasitam. Balakasya hasitam. The boy's laugh. In English also it works similarly, so this is easy to understand. When we use 32102 nishtha to denote an action in the past tense, then the connecting word takes tritiya vibhaktihi, balakena hasitam. But when we use the same affix kta using the sutram 33114 napumusake bhave ktaha, then the connecting word takes shashti vibhaktihi, as in balakasya hasitam. So this will help us figure out in usage when we see the affix kta being used. Is it by 32102? Is it by 33114? First of all, 33114 only applies in the neuter gender. So if the word is not neuter, it cannot be 33114. Second thing is that, look at the connecting word. If 33114 is used to derive a word, then the connecting word takes the shashti vibhaktihi, like balakasya hasitam. On the other hand, if we use 32102, then the connecting word takes the tritiya vibhaktihi, balakena hasitam. This is going to help us figure out whether the ktanta pratipadikam is derived using 33114 or 32102. Both are used bhave. And also, one more thing is that 32102 is only used to denote an action in the past tense. So if it is not the past tense, then it's not 32102. So please keep these important points in mind so that we can distinguish between the kta prescribed by 33114 and the same affix kta prescribed by 32102. Okay, derivation here is very straightforward. Let's take the example hasitam, derived from the verbal root has, which is hase, hasane, from the bhvadiganaha. We take the verbal root, add the affix kta by this sutram, because we're deriving a word to be used in the neuter gender, and it's in the sense of bhave. So we start with has plus kta 33114, remove the it letter kakaraha, valashakvat dhitetasya lopaha vigat has. Bring in the idagamaha by 7 to 35, ardhadhatukasyed valadehe, and adyantau takitau, the augment it joins at the beginning of the affix, so we get has it the, remove the it letter, the ending takara of the it augment is a it letter by halantyam 133 tasya lopaha, so we get the pratipadikam hasita, decline like vana or phala. So the prathama ekvachanam is hasitam. This is a very important sutram, and very important here is to keep the distinction between 32102 and 33114 very clear in our mind.